Hi, my name is Alan from Alan Wee Property. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. In today's video, I'm going to talk about aging HDB flats. Can buy or buy? I know even before I begin this topic, I will receive a lot of haters who will slam my video because I'm going to talk about this extremely sensitive topic. Will price decline ahead with a decaying lease? Then, what will happen to them when their lease reaches zero? Will HDB come and rescue them? What about their prices in the meantime? Especially now with a massive supply of MOP BTO flats flooding the market and taking in the limelight. How are older flats going to stand a chance? Will home improvement program help to preserve its value and so on? If you are the many owners staying in such flats, please watch on as this video will give you some insight on what should you expect down the road. Let's head over to the discussion. Most recently, I attended a property wealth system training organized by my new company, PropNex. I will share more on this course at the end of this video. Anyway, in this slide, it showed that by 2025, a massive 547,000 units will have less than 59 years of balance lease, or flats that are built in 1985 and earlier. This means out of the total HDB dwellers of 1.1 million, 49.4% will be 40 years old or more. This means close to 50% of HDB flats in Singapore will have a remaining lease of less than 60 years old. In another 10 years' time, easily more than half will have a balance lease of less than 50 years. This means it has crossed the psychological halfway mark. Here, what does it mean for homeowners in Singapore? Some of you here will ask me, Alan, what will happen to my HDB flat when the lease is zero? Will HDB top up my lease? Here, you can tan ku ku ho. This article has already said it all. This is the pioneer HDB flats in Geylang. They are returned back to the state once their lease has expired. Here, let's explore the possible solution. First thing in mind, top up the lease. If SLA allow HDB flats to top up their lease for aging flats, what does it mean for homeowners? Well, assuming their 50 years old HDB flat is currently fetching 500,000 today, do you think the homeowners will sell 500,000 tomorrow when their lease is topped up back to a fresh 99 years? If this is really happening, this means most Singaporeans will become millionaire going forward. What does this mean for those in private properties? Will they also request to top up their lease? This will be never ending. This will also spell the end of this tiny red dot. Secondly, allow the lease to lapse. Rightfully, this is the correct thing to do. As stated in SLA website, it stated that, in general, the government policy is to allow lease to expire without renewal. In land scarce Singapore, we need to recover land upon lease expiry to reallocate it to meet fast-changing social economic needs. However, this will cause a lot of unsettling to those staying in such old flats. Will the government of the day do it? Well, this is a hot potato issue. Remember, when their property value is at stake, humans are irrational at the ballot box. This brings me back to the next solution, SERS, or Selective En Bloc Redevelopment Scheme. In a Straits Times article dated 24th March 2017, back then, Minister of National Development, Mr. Lawrence Wong, published a blog post that the government will continue to maintain the strict selection criteria for blocks eligible for SERS. Noting that only 4% of HDB flats have been identified for SERS since it was launched in 1995. This means SERS cannot be repeated across Singapore. This is not sustainable. What can the government do? Back in Parliament, then Minister Lawrence Wong on rejuvenating HDB flats and estate.
Explain the broad concept of VERS and how it is different from SERS. SERS is limited to precincts where there is high development value to be unlocked. Because of the value unlocked, we share this value with residents through generous compensation and the acquisition can be made compulsory. In the case of VERS, we expect more flats to be eligible as the intention is to space out the redevelopment of the town. But the compensation term for VERS will be less generous than SERS because we will be redeveloping land that is more built up. So VERS will be offered on a voluntary basis and residents will get to vote. We have outlined the broad concept of VERS, but there are still many details to be worked out, and we will need time to do so. This includes the extent of coverage of VERS and how the compensation will be computed. In particular, we will ensure that we implement VERS in a fiscally sustainable way so that it does not become a burden for the next generation. For residents who do not get VERS for their flat or who do not poll in favour of VERS, they will continue to live in their flats, which would have benefited from two rounds of upgrading. If they need a place at the end of the lease, the government will help them get another flat to live in. It could be a new flat from HDB for those who are eligible, a resale flat on a shorter lease, or a two-room flexi flat for retirement. So we will have various options to cater to diverse needs.
As for HDB website, VERS will only commence when flats are left with 70 years onwards. This is a voluntary scheme. It's like HIP. You vote for it, if you don't achieve the majority, no VER. You stay put and let the lease run out. If you got VER, which will be launched in about 20 years from now, and this is only applied to selected flats around 17 years or older. Selected precinct to vote on the government offer to buy back flats. Here, don't expect a windfall. The money may help you buy back a replacement flat with a shorter lease. On this note, let me share with you that HDB on the 1st of June 2024 announced that over 95 million was set aside to fund 23 upgrading projects in HDB neighborhoods, benefiting more than 15,600 households. These are some of the housing estate and precinct. If you happen to see your block here on this list, this means you can continue to stay put in the foreseeable future. If your aging flat are not on this list, maybe one day HDB may have plans for you. Don't say I never hint you, but the big question is, when? And can you wait for it? This brings me back to my last question. What if I'm staying in an aging HDB flat with a depreciating lease? Will my value continue to hold? Can I continue to buy, or should I sell it now? What better way to study aging HDB flat than through numbers? I will use three clusters of flats in Bukit Merah for my analysis. Firstly, I will use a very old flat in Block 120, Bukit Merah. This flat is 51 years old and has a remaining lease of 48 years. Based on the last transacted price of 550,000, the average PSF is 581. Next on the list are these flats opposite Bukit Merah Hawker Centre. They are 28 years old and left with a remaining lease of 71 years. Based on the average transacted price of 880,000, the average PSF is 750. Okay, pretty decent in terms of PSF for the mature HDB flat. The last cluster is these newer flats that just MOP and always hit the headline. They are known as City View at Henderson. They are 6 years old and have a remaining lease of 94 years. Based on the average transacted price of 986,000, the average PSF is 1,065. Here, what do these three sets of numbers relate to us? It means that if money is not enough and you die want to stay in this location because of family needs, then go and buy a old HDB flat with half its lease gone. This is like buying a COE car. If you have a moderate amount of money and don't want to buy a too old flat and cannot afford to pay millions for the newer flat, then please go for those mature flats at 750 PSF. This is like buying a second-hand car. As for those that have money and want to buy a brand new car, please go ahead and buy the newer flats that cost close to $1 million or 1,000 per square feet. I think this is still decent as compared to private property nearby. That is why MOP HDB flat will continue to go up with escalating private property prices. Again, some of you here may say that this is not accurate due to the difference balance lease. Okay, fair enough. Let me compute its value based on a linear depreciation, just like cars. For older flats, their linear depreciation is 11,000 per annum. For mature flat, its depreciation is 12,000 per annum. And for newer flats, its depreciation is 10,000 per annum. The difference between the numbers is not very conclusive in my opinion. Here, what if you compute them based on SLA leasehold versus freehold table, or commonly known as BALA table? For the older flats, it depreciates at 8,400 per annum, as compared to the two other clusters at more than 10,000 per annum. Suppose we look at this angle. It seems the rate of depreciation is lower for the older flats, and this means they are far better value. However, hold on first. We have yet to see HDB flats transaction reaching towards its tail end of its lease. Therefore, it's not conclusive to use this set of numbers. In addition, there will be VER offered by the government that will tilt the game. Nobody knows what will happen then. I can only conclude that older flats will still have their demand in land scarce Singapore. This has been proven by past transactions. I recall I sold 2 units at block 120 Bukit Merah back in 2022. Back then, these are record prices. But here, what happened next? Someone has unseated my last record. This also shows that old flats can also appreciate in value in tandem with the rise in the overall property market. However, when property prices start to fall, coupled with a decaying lease and restriction to use CPF funds and housing loans, this means such flats will be less desirable and buyers will be far and few. Buyers want to buy with certainty. This is human nature. I do not want to lose sleep over a flat that will lose its value in the coming years. This is not an asset anymore, but rather a liability instead. For those who have the means to move on, you should seriously do so. For those that can't, you can only wait patiently for SERS or even VERS to happen. Lastly, this is a special invitation to an exclusive 2-day property wealth system masterclass at Suntec Convention Center, conducted by industry expert. You will be guided along on how to invest in a safe and low-risk method. Keynote speakers include my CEO, Ismail Gafo, Deputy CEO, Kevin Fong, KAO, Lim Yok Hock, and CAO, Eddie Lim. This event is highly sought after, so be quick. As an agent, I pay $397 to attend. But for consumer, it's only $97. Damn cheap, right, for 2 days of training. What are you waiting for? Kindly register with the links below and key in my numbers as the referral code. Very much appreciated. Lastly, when I was on stage to answer some questions, I can't help to take a selfie with my new boss. Some say he's the Andy Lau of the Singapore property market. What do you think? That's all for now, and see you in the Property Wealth System Masterclass.